Hey all, here at OS Reviews. So Android 10, also known as Android Q, has been out now for a week and a half, and after using it for a few days, here's a quick video that summarizes some of the biggest changes that impact how I use the device, just from my observations. But the most impressive thing was on day one of its official release, the update was pushed over the air to all the Google phones, including the Google Pixel 1 that was released in 2016. Though a phone that's now over 3 years old is still receiving the latest and fastest software updates. And also along the same lines, the OG Essential phone that is now over 2 years old also got an instant day one update to Android 10, which is just pretty crazy for a non-Google device from another third-party manufacturer, and really shows Essential's commitment. So one of the biggest things that you can now access on Android 10 is a dark mode for the entire system. So we can see how that includes even all the assistant, the shades, as well as the drag down notification actions, including the drawer. Everything is in this dark color, which preserves battery life, especially on flagship phones these days with AMOLED displays. The second most significant change would be the overhaul of the gesture navigational system. You can see here how on the bottom here, the icon is a lot smaller than it used to be. Here's basically what it looks like on Android 9 Pi, and you can still tap on this button back in the day to act as a home key, and there's also a back key that took up a portion of the display, but now it's just become smaller and smaller. These days, it relies 100% on the swipe up gesture to exit an application, so I can just pull up like this and it leaves, gives us also a quick indicator of a few arrows on the sides of the screen. So it relies on this motion, very similar to actually iOS and kind of like BlackBerry OS and WebOS from all those years ago. But now this motion is finally really smooth, it's responsive, and it's consistent and easy to use. Now to multitask, we can still swipe up partially and then go over to the left or to the right to access our open applications, and we can still flick up to close one out, as well as to tap on one to go back in. It's still pretty seamless, but now we can also use this bar directly to swipe over to go back and forth between our open applications. On any application, even third-party ones like the browser, you can just swipe over from the edge of the screen, and that takes you back. So there's the back gesture, which works pretty well on either side of the screen, on any portion as well, and that does the same thing. It's the same gesture found already on many proprietary skins, for example, on Xiaomi's MIUI. That was something that was already implemented, but was done really well. So finally, Google has borrowed that gesture over. There are some other minor tweaks, like the fact that notification shades are a little bit different. We're also able to see the presence of additional icons and controls. There is a quick shortcut now whenever you tap on the power key, for example, that accesses your emergency contacts, a quick 911 call. But these are relatively minor. Now, the third most important difference, in my opinion, would be the ability for you to smart compose or automatically reply using AI to quick messages and notifications right from the drag down drawer. Other additions, which I didn't get a chance to use quite as much in my day-to-day interactions, but could still be useful, include live captions. So you can play back media from your phone and you're able to see a pop-up of the captions, which are automatically parsed and presented to you from the phone's, again, ML and AI engine, without the need for even consuming Wi-Fi or cellular data. That includes offline content. Again, it's using built-in AI now to basically recognize the speech and then presenting it to you on screens. Android 10 also has a sound amplifier app built on in, which allows you to increase the volume of what you're listening to, say if there's a lot of background noise around you. Now, this is kind of a minor thing, and it's not really like active noise cancellation, nothing that fancy, because that would require hardware to do so, but it's still a nice little touch. Previously, you had to install your own amplifier app. Finally, some of the more minor updates which are going on behind the scenes include additional system optimization and also things that allow you to store and manage your privacy and data consumption more carefully. The EU GDPR, which mandates that all large companies like Google are able to first warn you that your data is being stored, and if you want to, you can also delete those data from your servers. So there's a more granular control in line with those regulations built onto Android. Really, the last thing to look at, if we go into About Phone, we can see that this is indeed running on Android version 10. If I tap on this for a few moments, we can check out the new kind of Easter egg. And this Easter egg actually is a puzzle, so that if you arrange the icons in a certain way to form the way the official Android 10 logo looks like, you basically can kind of beat this mini puzzle game of sorts. So overall, Android 10 does bring some welcome new features and additions that we've been asking for a while now. It's a very pleasant new update that hopefully you'll be seeing on more and more phones in the coming days. But overall, two thumbs up, and I think that's definitely an improvement over the previous Android 9 Pi in terms of the fluidity as well as its gesture and the dark theme, which I, again, do really like. But for now, that's been our video. Thanks for watching here at OS. reviews.